Hey guys, in this video, I'm gonna show you how to film yourself with your phone and to do it just like a pro. Now, when I started my channel over 2 years ago, I did not have a great quality camera to film all my videos. So the only solution I had was to use the phone that I'm using right now to film this video. So in this video, I'm gonna give you 7 of my best tips to film great quality videos with your smartphone. Let's get to it. I have a dream, that's all I need. I'll make it happen with some work and belief. Know what I want, so I'll take it on. I've made mistakes, but mistakes make you strong. Alright guys, I'm not gonna waste any of your time, so let's start with the first tip. Alright, now the first step is to use natural light. In fact, I'm recording this video right now with natural light. Now you gotta remember, never ever film yourself with the light behind you, meaning that the camera looks towards the light, as I'm showing you right now. So all you gotta do is open a door or a window to let the light in, and then record yourself while the light shines on your face. So the camera then, the phone, is right between you and the light. You gotta adjust the video settings on your phone. It's so simple, and yet so many people never do it. So open your camera on your phone, go to settings, go to videos, and select the highest quality for rear and front video size. Now remember, don't just go and shoot, but think a little bit, what do you want to use this video for? If it's for YouTube, for example, you want it to be landscape. If it's for Facebook or Instagram, then portrait might be better. The global tech protection and support company Azeron found that the average person struggles to go 10 minutes without touching their phones. Yeah, just think about that. Anyway, if you use your phone every 10 to 20 minutes over and over and over again, then of course the front lens and the rear lens, they're gonna get dirty. So you gotta clean it. And all you gotta do is to get lint-free cloth, all right? Then breathe a little bit on the lens, like that, get some moisture on it, and then you gently clean it. And then your videos will come out great. Press focus. Most people just take their phones and then just press record. But your phone doesn't really know what to focus on. You need to tell it. All you gotta do is to press with your finger where you want the camera to focus on. Change the angles. Of course, here it depends on what you want to film. So if you want to do something, some action or something interesting, then a lower angle might be better to show the shot. Or just a normal closer angle for a profile shot. And if you want to talk to the camera, then this height is okay. You see, the angle of the camera is just a little bit lower than my eye level, around here, and it looks great. And then a high angle can also work really well to show the setting. So don't just use the same setting, but change it up a little bit to get the perfect shot. Get phone accessories. There are 3 very important, affordable phone accessories that will definitely help you to record or film greater quality videos. A phone lens, a tripod, and this guy to put it on, a microphone, and then also this guy helps with those noises of the wind. Now you can still go without the tripod, you can stack some books and record yourself. You can go without the lens, but the most important thing is a good microphone. Now, when I started the channel, I did not have a good quality microphone, and people started to complain about the bad audio. If you don't believe me, go back to my first videos on this channel and you will, oh man, it's terrible. Anyway, first, I used this shotgun mic. It's really good because it cancels all the noise behind it and only focus on what's in front of it. And then later I got this guy over here that you can see, the lavalier mic. I'll add it all through in the video description so you can check it out. We're at the last one, and it is to get an editing program. You can increase the quality of your video a lot with editing by changing the brightness, for example, adding sharpness and the right color to your video. Then you can also add music and create interesting graphics. Now, I learned everything that I know about editing on YouTube, so you don't have to do a course about it, just watch some YouTube videos. And then also, you don't need to buy an editing program. You can use free ones. I used to use HitFilm 4 Express, and there's a few others. iMovie, Lightworks, Blender, Shotcut, and more. Now, just some last advice, and I'm gonna be very, very honest here. Your first videos will be your worst. It will feel uncomfortable, it will feel weird to talk into a camera. And I think only when I reached 100 videos, only then I started to have more confidence. And look, we all got to start somewhere. So my advice to you is to just start. And as you go, you will see your confidence is growing while your experience grows. And that will give you a lot more confidence in yourself to create more videos, and you're gonna start to see that more creativity, more ideas is gonna just come out. Now, if you're someone that tries to be a good person in this world, then you gotta do it. You gotta shine your light. There's a lot of bad influencers out there. There's a lot of bad videos out there. Edmund Burke said, "All that is required for evil to triumph is for good men to do nothing." So as I said, there's a lot of bad stuff on social media, and we need more good to change the world. It's time to shine your light. I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.